direct from Foxborough, Massachusetts, the gem of Norfolk County, and taped at the studios of Foxborough Cable Access. It's Foxborough Central, and here's your host, Bob Hickey.
Welcome to another great episode of Foxborough Central. I am your host, Bob Hickey, here talking to you about the people, events, and organizations that make Foxborough what? The gem of Norfolk County. That's right. Hey, we're here today with a very special episode. I am very happy, pleased, and honored to be joined by three good people here. First of all, Lauren Eliopoulos.
Yes.
I got it right.
You did.
Got it right. Lauren Eliopoulos, Amanda Dickerman, and Dan Cahill. Welcome, everybody. So
thank
nice
you.
To see you here today. Why are we here? We're here for a very special cause. This is something that is just a story of a need being filled by two people who said, hey, we're going to do it, right?
Exactly.
That's how it started.
That's how it started. So how did it start? First of all, what we're talking about here are Hero Helpers of America. This is a grassroots organization started by, if I may call you, Amanda and Lauren.
Yes.
All right. I'm going to do that because I don't think I can get through Eliopoulos.
It's really long.
It's a grassroots organization that was started to essentially send care packages to servicemen and women serving overseas.
True.
Yep.
But more.
Right. We also do a whole lot of like fundraising and letter writing and volunteer like pairing with soldiers.
Events.
Yep. We just had a really successful one
with
last month at Jay Barrows.
I see. And Jay Barrows, of course, is our representative here in Massachusetts at the State House. But this is not just a Foxborough thing, is it?
No. We actually just got two new groups. One's in South Carolina. And one's in New York City, and we hope to be in every state at one point.
That's amazing. And this all started because you two had an idea.
7 weeks ago.
7 weeks ago. So, for those of you at home, you may not know when 7 weeks ago is. Let's just say in a very short amount of time, these two very energetic young ladies have put together this concept and have put together some organizations outside of Foxborough. In Foxborough, you've done drives to create care packages.
Yes.
But it sounds like it's so much more. But let's talk about care packages first of all. Getting together a care package, why would anybody, and Dan, of course, you're in the service and you have friends who have served overseas, why would we need to put together a care package? Don't they have everything they need?
No, not really. Well, they tell you you have everything you need, but you know, at the end of the day, I think you know you kind of want to settle down and have something to remember that reminds you of home. And something to look forward to.
Now, it's interesting Absolutely. That we, and I'm going to get to this question of what all is involved, because I remember several years ago, a good friend of mine who lives here in Foxborough, in the first of his three deployments overseas, he asked his wife, said, look, we have nothing to do over here. Can you put something together? And our neighborhood, because we love him and his wife, our neighborhood got together and we put together sports equipment and t-shirts for different teams.
That's awesome.
So that way they'd be able to have something to do to break the team. And it's one thing to serve the country, but it's another thing to be completely bored. And so by putting it together, and that was the easy part, getting the equipment, the softball equipment and everything. But getting it to them ended up being such an ordeal, and I just remember that was my takeaway from it, was that no matter how much good you wanted to do, there was such a lot of red tape and rigmarole to go through. Is this something that you're dealing with also today?
Absolutely. So we do tons and tons of care packages. I mean, probably like way over 100 a month as so far. And just doing the custom forms.
That's an amazing startup, if you will.
Yeah.
Again, you said 7 weeks ago, and again, I'm not going to get into what 7 weeks ago was, but in a short amount of time, you've created an organization here that's generating enough donations, and I imagine dollars, to put these together.
Yep, absolutely.
And it's now expanded to New York and South Carolina, and a little bird has told me that you're also looking at Florida as your next location.
We are.
We're working on it.
That's exciting.
See how it pans out.
That's exciting.
We're hoping.
Yeah.
So getting a package together.
Yes. So it's not just getting the items and organizing the items. It's actually being like, okay, each package we want to have the same amount of stuff. Well, the same amount of stuff we get, like no one knows, like, oh, they need razors this week or they need deodorant. So just getting all of it together, putting in equal amounts of stuff, making sure the care packages are full. Mm-hmm. I mean, it's an ordeal. Then filling out all the paperwork, making sure the address is correct. If the address is not correct, by one, it could be one digit on a zip code, it gets sent back to us, and that $15 to ship it is gone.
And it's $15 a package.
A package. Mm-hmm.
So, and again, I work at a bank, but I'm not going to impress you with mine. Scott, we're talking this first shipment they sent over. You mentioned it was over $1,000 of shipping.
It's a lot more. So we're shipping out 129 packages this week. It's $1,950.
Wow.
Yes.
That's a piece of change. You have to raise that as well.
Right. Mm-hmm. Right. And then we have businesses like Dan who have generously donated. We have Dana Stores from DM Chimney.
Yes, yep. A local firm here in Foxborough.
We're also working with Foxborough VFW, who's donated a bunch of shipping costs, and they're trying to make it a monthly donation to us from them.
Yep.
Because this is not a one-time deal, what we're talking about here is something that you're hoping will grow and build and carry forward.
Right.
Absolutely.
Which is what makes this really sharp, is that it's not just a one-time project. You two are sort of committing to this.
Yeah, absolutely. It's definitely a commitment,
A lot of That's hours.
So you two just woke up one morning and said, we're going to do this. What is the motivation? Why?
It's a great question.
Why are you doing
this? My mom was actually writing. My brother's a Marine. My mom was writing to all these Marines in need who don't have family, don't have friends. So we started, me and Amanda were like, well, we can write too.
Well, wait a second. Yeah. Dan, is it true that no Marines have friends or family?
I don't think so. I think we're all family.
There you go.
Once you're in there, you're
a brother.
You're friends and family for life.
So. And so that's what we're really talking about here.
From home, though, you need, like we said before, you need stuff to remind you that there's something back home when, you know, that it's all worth it, that you're there and what you're doing, and that you're appreciated, you know.
Absolutely.
So there's the need.
Absolutely.
And you got involved because your brother's a Marine.
Absolutely. And her father is...
My dad was in Iraq for 2 years and Bosnia for 1 year when I was younger. So I wasn't really into the whole care package and writing. Like, I was only 11. So now that I'm 23 and I have, like, the resources to do all of this, it definitely feels good to do that. So.
And short aside, I remember you when you were there because your dad was in the JCs
for a couple of years.
Anyway, I'm so glad that Greg made it back and is healthy and that we're all healthy.
Absolutely.
But part of that is also mental health and keeping active and keeping, as you say, a remembrance of people back home appreciate what is being done. So with that, does a pack of razor blades really make that big a difference?
You know what? Probably not.
But,
it's the things they need. We actually started doing like rec items. So we'll put like a Nerf ball.
Or
we'll put a little
bat.
Word search books. Little things.
Silly
that they can
string. Little things to keep them busy.
They love silly string.
Play jokes with each other. So
we try to do a lot of that stuff.
Excellent. And so with this whole initiative of creating care packages, what if I, Bob Hickey, here in Foxborough, wanted to participate? What would you ask me to do?
Oh boy.
What
would you want to do?
I know, where about do a million, start?
There's like a million things you could do. So day-to-day things, I never realized, and Amanda too, the administrative tasks, printing stuff out, writing letters to people, and all of those things, packing boxes. Mm-hmm. It took me like 2 nights to pack, I think 87 boxes or something.
So you're looking for volunteers?
Mm-hmm. All the time.
And volunteers would be here and in New York and in South Carolina.
All
and
the time.
Presumably in Florida.
Yes.
Yes.
And what I'm going to ask you to do is put your microphone back on because I think it fell off. While you're doing that, we're going to continue talking about volunteers. So how, if I was a volunteer wanting to help, maybe somebody sitting at home wanting to help, how would they get in touch with you?
We have a Facebook page, herohelpers.com.
It's
facebook.com/herohelpers.
We have a website. It's herohelpersofamerica.org. They can also contact me or Amanda directly by phone.
Okay.
My phone number is 508-631-4758. I don't know your number.
Mine's 508-369-7906.
That's great, but it sounds like you have a website.
We do.
HeroHelpersOfAmerica.org.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
So to be a .org, that tends to tell me that this is a nonprofit. Is this a nonprofit?
It is a nonprofit.
Mm-hmm. So you two have kicked it up in a very short amount of time, created the organization, created the nonprofit status, and I understand that you're 501c3
pending. Mm-hmm.
So these would be tax deductible donations.
Absolutely. Any donation you give us, it could be $5, it could be $1 million, it's tax deductible.
And since we're also talking about South Carolina and New York and Massachusetts and Florida and who knows where, I used the example of Topeka before because it rolls out the tongue. So the best way to do that would be go to the website
www.herohelpersofamerica.org.
And then there would be
there's tons of information. There's also my personal email address, which is lauren@herohelpersofamerica.org, and Amanda's, as well as our general info one.
Right, so you're easy to get a hold of.
Very easy.
Yeah.
And one great way to do it, and I'm not a Facebook guy, but to befriend it on Facebook will give you all the information as well.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely.
Our That's page good. Constantly being updated.
You know, probably 10 times a day at some point.
Yeah. So you're having fun doing this?
Yeah.
Yeah, I love it.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah, it makes you feel good.
It's a very feel-good thing, but as we all know, with any type of organization, and you own a local business, so you mm-hmm. certainly would know, Dan.
Yep.
It doesn't matter how much fun you have, but the devil's in the details, as my friend Mike Stanton would say.
Right.
And the administration can always become a bit overwhelming. Are you looking for help with that as well?
Yes, absolutely. I could literally spend 30 hours a week just doing administrative tax, writing tax letters to people. Keeping up with the names, we actually do a Letters from Home project, mm-hmm. which we pair up volunteers locally and from afar, and they get a serviceman who doesn't have family. Just, you know, an extra letter of motivation, an extra card, a thinking of you. Just keeping that list up to date and giving our volunteers the information, sending out to the serviceman or woman, sending them out a letter saying, hey, this is what we're about. We're pairing you up with someone. You're going to be getting packages from us. You know, it's a lot of work. It is.
So you have needs other than just giving stuff. You have letter writing.
Absolutely. Mm-hmm. We have letter writing, and we also are going to try to start working with veterans. We're going to be doing some fun events to help veterans homeless shelters. So we don't just want to stay with people who are overseas or in boot camp. We want to expand and help anyone who's helped us.
I hope you two have quit your jobs and are now able to do this full time. It sounds like an extraordinarily mature project, given that, as you say, only 7 weeks. And I'm just so impressed with not only how well-spoken you are, but with the whole idea and how it's coalesced into an action plan.
Yeah, it was not intended to get this big, and it just did, and we're really happy about it.
So
yeah.
How did it start? What was the first thing? You just woke up one day and thought it was a good idea. So what did you do?
Lauren's mom was writing to a couple of Marines, and we were like, oh, well, let's write too. So then I was like, I want to send the Marine I'm writing to a care package. And Lauren was like, well, yeah, let's do that.
Let's
and
make
they
it
were
a
like,
thing.
Let's make it a thing. So let's do this for all the people that need care packages or need letters. So.
And well, then the from next, that small thing.
It got huge. And the next day, we started getting emails. I posted a Facebook status saying, if you know anyone in need, the next day.
And then it was like a list.
A list.
10 pages long.
So there's a need.
Yeah. Oh, there is, yes. Mm-hmm. And you hear these stories sometimes, it just breaks your heart. There was one kid who is deployed. I believe he's in Afghanistan right now. And his family is extremely poor, so he sends all his paycheck every single month to his mom. Mm-hmm. Very supportive family, no money to send him a care package. So we've taken it up that we send him like 2-3.
Wow.
Every time we send out care packages, because he has, I mean, just socks, like clean socks, the little Crystal Light packages, mm-hmm. anything.
Energy,
like they love it. You know,
drinks,
it helps them.
Protein bars.
Well, that shows there's also a great need, because if this kid is sending his money home and he's out there putting himself in harm's way,
mm-hmm. yeah.
it's a small thing that we can do.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
Wow.
And it makes you feel good.
Well, there's the need, folks. Again, you can log on to www.herohelpersofamerica.org to find out the best way to contribute, to participate. And it sounds like you also need volunteers for packaging. But we're also looking at cash donations, no?
Yes, absolutely.
Because postage
Definitely.
Costs money. And Dan, you're here because I understand your company, you've made a commitment and you're donating cash on the barrelhead to help
yes.
with postage.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Cahill on hair.
And so that's Long a great way for businesses to get involved. And the way I found out about you two was our representative, Jay Barrows, turned me on to what you're doing.
And he also gave us a cash donation.
Through the Barrows Insurance
Agency. Yes, he did, $250. And DM
so it doesn't have to be $1 million.
No, it can be 50, it can be 25, it can be 10. We've gotten someone just hand us a, you know, a $20 bill. Amanda works at the VFW mm-hmm. and one guy just, you know, every few weeks throws us a $20 bill. Well, that ships one package. Mm-hmm. It's huge. That's huge.
So every little bit helps.
Every mm-hmm. little bit helps.
And again, it's a nonprofit organization, so donations are tax deductible.
Absolutely.
So if I were looking to, we've already talked about cash, and we've already talked about volunteering. What if I have stuff, or is there a list of stuff? How do I know what stuff you two are looking
for? Oh, we have a big list.
So I assume you two are coordinating, you're not just sending any old stuff.
Right. I mean,
you wouldn't send something silly like baby wipes, would you?
Oh, actually, baby wipes are good.
Why are baby wipes good?
Well, they don't get to shower all the time, so carrying them around gives them a quick wash up and feel Absolutely. A little bit cleaner.
So I was being a little silly, but
actually,
really the way to find out what is needed is to go to your website or to contact you directly. But go to the website, gives you all the information.
It does. Yep. Right. It has a whole list of things we need. We're also going to be updating the list on what we need right now. This week we might need razors, for instance, or this mm-hmm. week we might need baby wipes, and next week we might need toothbrushes.
And through the beauty of the internet, and hopefully folks outside of Foxborough are watching this, they'll see this and they'll say, this week we need something, to log on to herohelpersofamerica.org, and they can find out what they
Absolutely.
Need this week. Mm-hmm. But money is always a good thing. Cash is king, as they say.
Absolutely.
And unfortunately, since America does take that world policeman role very seriously, even mm-hmm. when Afghanistan does end, the need will still be there, and it's a constant need, correct?
There's always a constant need. Even though there might not be Afghanistan, there is servicemen, Marines, Navy, who are deployed on MUs. And what a MU is, it's a military ship. So they could go into Syria, for instance. They could be protecting our borders. And they could be out there for months and months and months mm-hmm. and have no some of them have no communication. Some of them don't receive care packages for 2 months after you send them. But it's really important to always give back, and this is something that's going to be ongoing for hopefully forever, hopefully even after we're gone.
I was talking with a Marine earlier today who had been deployed ahead of a troop action, and so he was in that situation for, I believe it was 9 months before the main body came aboard, came ashore. So that's an absolute need that you're
Absolutely.
Kind of touching on, and I know that it's not really appropriate, and I'm not going to divulge any secrets, Mr. Marine, over there. thank you for your service, but it's a very real need that people may not even have the ability to clearly define, but you two are saying that there is a need and you have this conduit. So folks at home who may have a good heart and want to help but not know how, you have the way to do it.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely. Absolutely. Mm.
Or if somebody has a soldier or a Marine overseas and they can't pay to ship their package out, they could put a package together, bring a bunch of stuff that they wanted specifically to go to their person, and we can pay to ship it out for them.
Kind of help.
Yeah, mm-hmm. absolutely. And if there's ever a local family that has a serviceman, and even if they're not in need, we'd love to hear about it because it's Foxborough. I'm a Foxborough graduate. She's a Foxborough graduate, born and raised, essentially. Like, we want to give back to our community.
Or New York or South
or
Carolina.
Or New York or Florida. South Carolina, Florida.
But you know, it's not, you raise a great point, and that's how you get involved. And in every community, I assume there's one or two people that see this, are touched by the movement, and are moved by the story, and want to help and can do this in their own locale. So
Absolutely.
This is something that can grow and is growing, obviously,
it's
very
expanding
quickly.
So right. quickly.
My God.
It's just amazing. This is such a short amount of time, Dan. And these two girls.
It can be overwhelming, you know. I know what they
he understands.
I started a business that it grew very quickly, and the administrative just
it's crazy.
7 days a week, and you really need as much help as you can get.
Well, it's truly a good story. Now, I understand at the end of this program, we are going to be able to enjoy, and you'll enjoy at home, a short clip that is more about the nuts and bolts and what you're looking for, and touching on some stories, perhaps?
Yes. There's a lot of photos of Afghanistan and, you know, what they endure, what everyday life is for them. And it actually was so moving for me to put this together because I didn't realize that some of these guys are literally sleeping in holes. Mm. They are sleeping in tents that have dirt floors. I mean, we take the little things for granted. It's very crazy.
Mm. Folks, this is a very compelling message, and I'm looking forward to seeing that video at the end, which will really drive the point home, I'm sure. In the meantime, I'm going to give everybody a last word, because time has grown so short, you're going to have to make that a handheld mic, my friend. That's all.
Got it.
Dan, since you have it in your hand, what would you like to impart upon the business community who maybe had the opportunity and the resources to contribute to this cause?
Well, I think, you know, like we did with this, you know, even if you donate some of your services or some money or whatever, you know, it goes a long way.
It does.
I think you make a donation, take part in it, and ask them if they need anything. And, you know, it really goes a long way for the troops. I mean, like you said, at the end of the day, when there's nothing in the waiting and the, you know, the if it's a week, 2 weeks, or 2 months of doing absolutely nothing, you need something to do or something to even look at or read.
Absolutely.
Or, you know, have hope and a reason to fight or a reason to keep waiting and being bored. Know that when you're coming home that, you know, have a reminder of what you're coming home to, because you do forget. And they sleep in holes and they go over there because they want to. They signed up for it and they like it. Don't feel bad for them and don't ask for pity, and you know, but say thank you and appreciate the freedom that they're fighting for. And that's all.
Well said. Dan Cahill, thank you for your service, and Daniel of Cahill Lawn Care here in Foxborough. Amanda and Lauren, I'm just so impressed. What
thank
is
you.
The last word that you would like to give to everybody? Donate. Help.
Yeah, donate to us, help us. It's a great cause, and support our troops.
Very good.
I think people don't understand what it's like to have a military family. And what I mean by that is, if you don't have a sibling, if you don't have a mom, a dad, a cousin, an uncle who's been in the service, you don't understand what it takes, how much effort it takes for them, and what it literally takes out of them. So I guess I want people to be aware that it's hard. It's hard for me. My brother's going to Afghanistan, and it's hard to take it in. And that's why I want to give back to all these people. And even if you can only donate Sports Illustrated magazines that you're subscribed to, that you read already, they love that. Anything, any little bit helps.
Mm-hmm. Well, thank you, Lauren. Thank you, Amanda, for all the work you're doing. And on behalf of Foxborough Cable Access, we really thank you for coming out and sharing your story. For folks at home who want to contribute, again, go to herohelpersofamerica.org. I'm now going to leave you with this short clip about some of the stories behind the reason why Lauren Elianopoulos and Amanda Dickerman are putting this together, doing this wonderful project. I hope you'll get involved. I hope you'll volunteer. I hope you'll donate. Take care. Thank you so much for coming
out.
Thank
you so much.
Thank you.
Thanks for having us.
Thank you. Enjoy this clip.
I'm just trying to be a father, raise a daughter and a son, be a lover to their mother, everything to everyone. Up and at 'em bright and early, I'm all business in my suit. Yeah, I'm dressed up for success, from my head down to my boots. I don't do it for the money, there's bills that I can't pay. I don't do it for the glory, I just do it anyway. Providing for our futures, my responsibility. Yeah, I'm real good under pressure, being all that I can be. I can't call in sick on Mondays when the weekend's been too strong. I just work straight through the holidays, sometimes all night long. You can bet that I stand ready when the wolf growls at the door. Hey, I'm solid, hey, I'm steady, hey, I'm true down to the core. And I will always do my duty, no matter what the price. I've counted up the cost, I know the sacrifice. Oh, and I don't wanna die for you, but if dying's asking me, I'll bear that cross with honor, 'cause freedom don't come free. I'm an American soldier, an American. Beside my brothers and my sisters, I will proudly take a stand. When liberty's in jeopardy, I will always do what's right. I'm out here on the front lines, sleep in peace tonight. American soldier, I'm an American soldier. Yeah, an American soldier, an American beside my brothers and my sisters. I will proudly take a stand when liberty's in jeopardy. I will always do what's right. I'm out here on the front line, so sleep in peace tonight.